家了，今天上午刚拿回来。
幸亏啊，是采访推迟了。
哎，以后肯定不会有这样的事情了。
哎，对了，明天咱们几点去啊？采访的地点换了吗？
时间和地点都没变。
哦，好的，我知道了。嗨，张记者，你还认识我吗？
嗨 ，Mike， 怎么是你？你什么时候来北京的？
我到北京已经三天了，为了采访这一次奥运会。
哦，是这样。
啊，来，你先坐。
好。
坐。
那你这次打算在北京待多久？
大概两三个月，然后就继续回美国记者站工作。
真没想到我们能在北京见面。
嗯，
走，喝咖啡去，咱们好好聊聊。
好，等我一会儿好吗？我得先把这份文件给小芳送过去。
好，我就在这儿等你。
好。
Let's pause there for a moment and talk about some background information. In Chinese, mascot is known as 吉祥物, literally an auspicious object, something that brings you good fortune. There are five 吉祥物, mascots, for the Beijing 2008 Olympic Games, known as 福娃, to match the five Olympic rings. Bei Bei is the fish. In China's traditional culture and art, fish are symbols of prosperity. Jing Jing is the 福娃 in the form of a panda.The lotus designs in Jing Jing's headdress, which are inspired by the porcelain paintings of the Song Dynasty, represent the desire to preserve the beauty of nature for all generations. In the intimate circle of Fuwa, Huan Huan is the big brother. He's a child of fire, symbolizing the Olympic flame and the passion of sport. The fiery designs of his head ornament are drawn from the famed Dunhuang murals.The antelope Ying Ying is fast and agile and can swiftly cover great stretches of land as he races across the earth. His head ornament incorporates several decorative styles from the Qinghai, Tibet, and Xinjiang cultures and the ethnic design traditions of Western China. The fifth Fuwa, Nini, draws inspiration from the golden-winged swallow kites of China, traditionally one of the most popular designs. Swallow is also pronounced Yan in Chinese.And Yanjing is what Beijing was called as an ancient capital city. Now let's take a closer look at a few of the vocabulary items from today's lesson. The first piece of vocabulary we have today is 联系.
联系.
联系, to contact somebody. 联系. Let's look at the next one. 闭幕式.
闭幕式
That's a closing ceremony. 闭 means to close. 封闭 关闭 to close. 幕 literally is the curtain. So close the curtain. A ceremony to close the curtain. 闭幕式
闭幕式
How would you say opening ceremony?
开幕式
开幕式 Right. Let's look at the next one. 聊聊
聊聊
聊聊 is to have a conversation or a chit-chat. Now like often when we have the verb repeated like that, the second verb...is pronounced in the light tone, the neutral tone, 聊聊。
聊聊。
Yeah, instead of 聊聊, we just say 聊聊。Okay, next one. 落在。
落在。
To forget something somewhere. 落在什么地方。
落在。
Now this character has another pronunciation. Do you know what it is?
落。
落, and what would that mean?
To fall.
Yeah, like 树叶落下来, the tree leaves are falling, 落下来。But here it's pronounced, 落, 落 is to forget something, to leave it somewhere. 落在车上, to leave it in the car.
So here, is the second character, 在, is that pronounced with the fourth tone, or is it the neutral tone?
Definitely with the fourth tone. 落在, you wouldn't do that, the neutral tone here would be 落在.
落在.
Okay. Let's take a moment now to go over some of the grammatical points that we covered in this lesson. Now, 什么时候 is an expression we can use to ask about time in general. It could be a time of day, it could be a time of year, it could be any point in the future. 什么时候, or in the past even. If we want to ask about a specific time on the clock, like what time of day, we'd say 几点. The answer to 什么时候 could be any time. The answer to 几点 would be a specific time on the clock.Pay special attention to these two phrases when we look at some of the sample dialogues now.
小韩，闭幕式什么时候举行？
嗯，
好像是8月24号。
明天我们几点到奥运村？
上午10点。
Okay, let's look at another pattern. 已经 something 了 is an expression used to show that an action has ended. 已经 verb 了. For instance, we could say 已经去过了 I've already been before. Let's take a look at an example of that.
走，咱们一块吃饭去。
谢谢，我已经吃过了。
这篇报告我已经写完了，你能帮我翻译一下吗？
好的，没问题。
谢谢。
Okay, here's another one. 一会儿 This is to express a short period of time. 一会儿 a very short period, maybe a few minutes or a few moments. 一会儿我们在这里休息一会儿 We'll rest a little while here. Pay special attention to this pattern when we look at the next sample.
你好，请问张明在吗？
不在，他在开会。你过一会儿再来找他吧。
Well, that brings us to the end of today's lesson. Today we've been talking about time. Of course, the way you express tenses in Chinese is very different from the way we do it in English. But we learned that we can use very simple structures like 已经 verb 了 to show that the action of the verb has already been completed.Or we could use a phrase like 一会儿 with a verb to show that the action is taking place over a period of time. 玩一会儿 to play a while. Now, if you'd like to review anything or you missed any of the previous lessons, remember, you can always go back to our website at english.cctv.com. Okay, that's all the time we have for today. We'll look forward to seeing you here next time on Sports Chinese. Bye for now.
Hello and welcome to